If you're just getting started with 3D printing, this may be a great place to start. This is the latest installment of the Ender 3 Neo, and it's got some great upgrades compared to the Ender 3 Pro. Let's take a look at it on today's Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you by the generous donations of these Patreon supporters. I purchased this Ender 3 Neo on Amazon myself for $239. I believe that's the retail price at Creality. This one is an Ender 3 Pro that I picked up at Micro Center. Now, I paid $199 for this, but many people who are new customers get a coupon. You can get one of these for $99. That's a heck of a deal. But this still may be the better way to go for a beginner. Let me explain. The Ender 3 Neo has many of the upgrades I've recommended in my videos that you do to an Ender 3 or Ender 3 Pro. The first one being the extruder top. The arm breaks on these things. It's plastic, it breaks underneath, you don't see it, you get extrusion problems. I did a video to replace that with a metal extruder top. This one already has it. That's $11 to put that on this machine, so there's part of the difference. Another item I've recommended you upgrade your Ender 3 or Ender 3 Pro to is a glass bed. This is a very thin aluminum and a very thin bed material. So when it heats up over and over, this center can actually warp up or down. So the center makes it hard to get a perfectly level bed. So that's why I recommend a glass bed. It's thicker, it's flat, and it works great. But that's a $16 increase on the cost of this. It's already included on the Neo. Another item I've recommended people do to this machine is put a silent driver control board on it. Your motors will be quieter, the machine will be quieter, and you'll get better prints. You'll actually get rid of that tiger striping that ends up on the front of a benchy right up here on the hull. Well, this one comes with it, and that's a $39 increase to this machine. Another upgrade that I think is perfect for the beginner is this auto level sensor. You can install one on this machine. You'll have to wire it, you'll have to update the firmware, and figure out the right bracket to put it in place. And it can be done. I've done videos on how to install auto level on an Ender 3 V2, but to put it on this machine takes some work. But you're looking at $39 for the sensor plus the work. Now, many people do it trying to get rid of that warp, and it doesn't really work because it does a 9-point probe, or you can do a 16-point probe, but it really is just averaging things. You still have a spot in your bed that the filament doesn't want to stick properly, or it's, you know, too close. So the glass bed is the way to go. And then once that's flat, then auto level works great. So that's what this has on it, already installed. So let's just take it at face value, $39 for the auto level sensor. Another little upgrade that they did is they put the heavy duty springs under the bed to support that glass bed. And it actually holds the bed level once you get everything adjusted. This has weaker springs, so the vibration of printing can actually loosen those a little bit. This holds a level much better. That's an $8 upgrade, pretty easy to do, but it's already installed in this machine. One final difference is the hot end. This has extra fins, larger fins for better cooling than this hot end. They both have the PTFE tubing going all the way down to the nozzle, which I don't like, but this one has better cooling. I have noticed slight improvement in print quality compared to this. So I'm liking this hot end a little better, but I'm not even gonna say there's a difference in cost. It's just different hot ends. This is the new one. This is the older style. I'm just gonna call it a wash for right now. Everything else is pretty much the same. The original Pros came with a Meanwell power supply. They no longer do that. They come with a Creality similar version. This has the same power supply. So that's no different. Same base, same frame, pretty much the same parts. Little different on the brackets here, but overall, pretty much the same. And they both come as a kit equal to assemble. This one's no easier or less easy than this. It's still a kit you gotta put together, but it's not that hard. Take you about 35 to 45 minutes to put it together. I'll have a video on how to assemble one of these in the near future. To total that up, you get $113 of extra features on this machine that you don't get here, right out of the box. But if you can get this for $99 and you spend that $113, you're still gonna be under. You're gonna be at $212 versus $239, but then you gotta do all the work. Now, if you like doing all that work, great. But if you're a beginner to 3D printing, I think you're going to find that very frustrating. So I would say this is a better place to start if you're just getting started with 3D printing, because everything installed, including that auto level sensor, which can be a real hassle to someone just getting started with 3D printing. Now, in reality, you don't have to upgrade this machine at all. You can take it out of the box, assemble it, and use it as is. And I highly recommend if you get one, do that. Learn what your machine is capable of. But these little things that I've mentioned are going to get you eventually, and you're going to want to upgrade. And that's why I love that they've done this. They've pretty much taken a lot of the ideas that I've said in my videos should be done to an Ender 3, and they put it in this machine. Now, if you've watched the channel in the past, you know I've recommended this, the Ender 2 Pro, as the perfect beginner printer. And I still really like it as a beginner printer. It's lightweight. It's easy to pack away. It's got a side spool holder. It's got the silent drivers. It's got belt adjusters. It's a smaller bed. And because it's a smaller bed, you don't have to worry about that warping as much. It does have a plastic extruder, so I recommend you replace that. But at about $169 to $179, you're not saving a whole lot, but it's definitely a very nice printer, and I still like it. So either one of these would be a good choice. But if you want the bigger bed, you want to print bigger things, this is probably the way to go. I've obviously run some test prints, but I need to do a lot more printing to really give you my opinion on that. But initially, the print quality I'm getting is quite good. And the bed level, I'm really happy with the auto level. It was easy to operate from the menu, and I got a perfect bed level first time. I'll put links to this in the description below if you want to get one yourself and do your own evaluation. If you like what I'm doing here, maybe check out some of the other videos popping up. If you want to help support the channel, Patreon is one way, or just buy through the affiliate links. It all helps. And if nothing else, click on that Filament Friday logo and subscribe. I'll see you next time right here at Filament Friday.